Hi guys, I'm Erica Parker, Queen of Real Estate, and I want to talk to you today about my story and just to introduce myself to all of you. So I grew up in Dallas-Fort Worth. I grew up in a city called Colleyville, and I went to college and got a degree in energy commerce. And I moved to Houston, and I did what any good college grad would do. I went and found a job. And I found a job in what I graduated in. And energy commerce is a fancy way of calling it a landman for oil and gas. And for 11 years, I negotiated contracts. I did deep water contract negotiations with the government, with other companies. I did business development, acquisitions, and divestitures. I did about $9 billion for my company. And, you know, and then I finally finished in that 11 years. I did 2 years in shale plays onshore. And I negotiated contracts. I wrote them. I talked to business owners. I talked to landowners. I did title research. I did due diligence to verify that someone owned what they said they owned. And at the end of it all, I thought that I was an integral part of the company. In the end, I was furloughed. During the pandemic, I was furloughed. And that took a hard hit to me because I had given 11 years of my life to this company, and I had made them $9 billion in mergers, divestitures, and acquisitions. I had done $9 billion worth. And to know that I was no longer essential to them, it was hard because I was loyal. And in this time of people jumping from company to company, I was one that was loyal. And so for them to furlough me, I just felt kind of betrayed. And I got to this situation of not really feeling like I was worth all of what I took a hit to my self-esteem. I took a hit to the person I was and that I knew myself to be because I was independent. You know, before I met my husband, I was fine with, you know, affording everything that I had and, you know, being with him. I love him, but I also felt this need to be independent financially, just to not be a burden onto anyone. I don't know why that is a situation that I've had mentally all the time, but I don't want to be a burden. And when I lost my job, I had to rely on my husband, and I started watching my kids. I've got two wonderful kids. I've got a 2.5-year-old boy and a almost year old girl. And at the time, she was about 6 months and he was about 2 years. And I started watching him, and I love my kids, but I also feel like I need something that is me and that represents me. And so I started doing some soul searching, if you want to call it that, and looking at what I felt passionate about. And I started going, I had gotten into real estate investing about 2.5 years ago, and I started doing some real estate investing on the side. I own about 7-8 properties right now, and I wanted to continue that and to be able to help not only people that were motivated to sell and needed to sell, but also help people that are just wanting to sell because they're needing to move, or they're being relocated, or whatever the case may be. I wanted to be able to help them as well. So I decided to get my real estate license. And I know this journey is gonna be hard. I know that I'm not gonna make the amount of money that I made in my last job in this first year, or maybe not. My goal is to do that. And I continually use self-education. I am a big proponent of self-education in reaching your goals. So, you know, if it's real estate, great. If it's another avenue that you want to get to where you're going, I highly recommend self-education and looking up, you know, mastermind.com, Udemy, any of the websites that provide several courses, online courses, I think that that's where our nation is headed. I think sometimes our education gets to the point that it's too expensive. I mean, our colleges have been going up exponentially on cost and have not really added anything. It's gone way more than what inflation is. And so I think that in the future, self-education is going to be a big part of it, and apprenticeships and going back to this, you know, figuring out what you want to do and then going and learning from the best at doing it. So it's almost like I feel like we're going to go back in time into what apprenticeships were and self-education. And even if it's an online apprenticeship, like, that's how you're going to learn. So that's my story. I continue to teach myself. I want to start teaching others what I'm learning and what I'm able to do in my investing and my agent businesses. And I just wanted to give y'all a little bit of a share of who I am and what my story is coming to this. I no longer work the 9-to-5. I'm very passionate about real estate. It makes me so happy that I'm in this job, and I'm smiling again. I've got my kids. I have the flexibility to go watch their activities if I want to, or be a part of it and volunteer. So I'm loving my choice. But whatever your choice is, I just wanted to let y'all know that this is my story, and I really want to be a proponent of y'all figuring out what your passion is and going after it.